A very warm welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. SBI assures cash crunch problem in some states will be resolved by Friday, says currency is being transported to areas which are facing shortage. People in smaller towns allowed withdrawals up to 2,000 rupees a day from POS machines free of charge. Judge B.H. Loya died a natural death, observes Supreme Court, dismisses all writ petitions that demanded an independent probe into the matter, expresses anguish over what it calls scandalous PILs attempting to malign the judiciary. Centre emphasizes series of steps in dealing with sexual offences. Union Minister Menaka Gandhi writes to state governments, urges top priority for completion of investigation in cases involving child victims, says police officers involving in the collecting evidence should be retrained. People of Kashmir should make an effort to bring back their displaced brethren to their native state, says Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu, calls it the duty of all nationalists to do justice to the dispossessed people. And Queen Elizabeth opens Commonwealth heads of the government meeting in London, suggests her son Prince Charles as the head of the Commonwealth to succeed her. Climate change and cyber attacks by nations set to be the major issues to be discussed at the summit. The 25th Commonwealth Heads of the Government meeting started in London today, along with other heads of the states. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is taking part in the summit for the first time. The forum is expected to have discussions on climate change, free trade, security, education and skill development. Earlier today, the Prime Minister also met heads of the many Commonwealth nations. And inaugurating the Chogham Summit, Britain's Queen Elizabeth II hoped Commonwealth will play a pivotal role for stability and continuity for future generations. UK Prime Minister Theresa May said climate change threats and state cyber attacks will be the major issues to be discussed at the summit. The two-day 25th Commonwealth Heads of the Government meeting started in London on Thursday. British Prime Minister Theresa May, along with the Commonwealth Secretary General Patricia Scotland, welcomed the heads of the Commonwealth nations. Inaugurating the summit, Queen Elizabeth II said, "The Commonwealth will continue to offer stability and continuity for future generations."
Being welcomed to opening ceremonies around the Commonwealth, it is a pleasure this time to welcome you to my own home.
She also appealed to Commonwealth leaders to appoint her son, Prince Charles, to succeed her as their head. The role is not hereditary and will not pass automatically to the Prince of Wales on the Queen's death.
By continuing to treasure and reinvigorate our associations and activities, I believe we will secure a safer, more prosperous and sustainable world for those who follow us.
Meanwhile, British Prime Minister Theresa May warned of global challenges in her opening remarks at the event. May told the Commonwealth leaders that threats from climate change and state cyber attacks are among the issues which are said to be discussed throughout the summit.
To seize the possibilities open to us as member countries and together to take on some of the 21st century's biggest questions. How we support our most vulnerable member states as we tackle climate change and improve the health of our oceans, creating a more sustainable Commonwealth. How we develop through trade, pushing back against protectionism for a more prosperous Commonwealth.
Representatives of 53 nations of the Commonwealth are participating in the summit. Two executive sessions have been organized in London's Lancaster House for the Commonwealth. The theme of this year's Chogum is Towards a Common Future. The leaders of the member countries will decide whether the Commonwealth can be developed as a new business and cooperation organization like ASEAN. Akhilesh Suman's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And for more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent, Akhilesh Suman, who is joining us live from London. Akhilesh, I would like to ask you, what is the agenda of this Chogum summit?
Yeah, Smriti, you know that there is a new situation in the world after European Union has been divided and Britain has come out of European Union. There is a new situation in the whole European system. And now Britain is very much interested to reinvigorate its old Commonwealth conglomeration that members are by default who had been under British Empire. And this is a very big conglomeration of 53 nations. There is some bond. This is a very diverse conglomeration when there are least developed countries, where middle income countries, and where developed economies like Australia and Canada. So you can understand that with such a diverse community of nations, there is a prospect of trade, there is prospect of technology cooperation, and also there is prospect of cooperation on the issues of international affairs. And Theresa May, while she was welcoming the Commonwealth heads of the government, she mentioned two things that is very specific. One, she told about the international rule-based system, and you can understand where the signal is. The signal is towards the country which is distorting the international rule-based system, and that is China. You know, that whole Indo-Pacific, Asia-Pacific region is being threatened by the upmanship of the Chinese monopolistic attitude. And it was the first word she has used in her welcome speech. And the second point, she very specifically mentioned about the cyber security from individuals and also from the state. And that is signaling towards Russia. Britain always accused that Russians are encroaching the cyberspace and they are hacking. And even the state of Russia is also involved in that. So given these two facts, you can understand that there is a new type of, that center is trying to be evolved. And right. India, being the largest democracy and also being the largest member of the Chogum, I think there is a prospect that India may contribute more. And that is why Prime Minister Narendra Modi is here, given the fact that he is talking to other one-to-one talks also. And today he has talked to 11 heads of government, including Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Prime Minister of Australia, Prime Minister of Mauritius, and also President of South Africa, among others. So this is the time when you also have your own agenda. We, India, also have its own agenda about the international reform, Security Council reform. And also we have agenda of international solar alliance. So we need also many members of the world to be in our side. So it is like win-win situation for both Britain and India to revitalize the whole Chogum. I think Prime Minister Narendra Modi is giving time. And just now sessions are going on. The executive session 2 is going on. And Prime Minister is intervening in very many different agenda of peace, prosperity, of development, of technology cooperation. There are so many agendas that is being put on the floor. And other heads of states are speaking on this issue, that how it can be conversed. And tomorrow when there will be retreat, they will again talk on the issues. And after that, by the evening, some agreement document will come in which you will see that how Chogum is going to take place and how it will take shape in the future, given the fact that, every country is looking towards India becoming not only a prospect market, but also a greenfield, that there are many places in India where you can invest. And there are many countries who want investment from India. So it will be interesting situation to see that how Chogum concludes tomorrow, Smriti.
Right, Akhilesh. And one more thing, that there is a consideration that Commonwealth can be developed as a new business and cooperation organization like ASEAN. Anything latest on that front?
Yeah, it will be interesting to see that the whole effort is that to create a cohesive grouping in Commonwealth. Then what will be the cohesive grouping mean for? The cohesive grouping will mean for easy trade. The free trade is being talked about by everyone. Even Prime Minister Narendra Modi yesterday told that there should be some free trade arrangement among the Chogam countries. Also, Theresa May is saying the same thing when she was talking to Prime Minister Narendra Modi yesterday. So trade is an inseparable part of this grouping. It has to be there. Only thing that has to be seen that how pushes and pulls come together, because you know that Pakistan is also in the grouping, and you know that who Pakistan advocates for. Pakistan advocates for China in today's world, and whether it will, since most of the things are decided on the basis of consensus, so how much intervention, how much influence can Pakistan do, and how much it can garner support from many other countries. So it will be cohesive group, it will be very strong group, it will be a very loose group. It will be interesting to see, and the action plan that follows for the whole year next year. So it is going to be somehow or other, it will be going to be evolved as a cohesive group, given the fact that it will be seen that how much cohesion is coming forward from various members in the grouping.
Thank you so much, Akhilesh, for joining us and giving us all those latest updates from London. We'll keep coming to you for more on this. Moving on, the Supreme Court on Thursday ruled there will be no independent investigation into the circumstances surrounding Judge B.H. Lohia's death. The apex court observed that Judge Lohia died a natural death and there was no doubt about that fact.
The Supreme Court on Thursday dismissed petitions seeking a special investigation team probe into the alleged mysterious death of Special CBI Judge B.H. Lohia. An apex court bench headed by Chief Justice of India Deepak Mishra passed the order. Dismissing the batch of petitions, the court said there is no merit in them. The apex court also observed that attempts are being made by petitioners to malign the judiciary. It also said there are no reasons to doubt statements of sitting judges. The apex court said the judge had died due to natural causes.
Court ne ye bhi kaha hai. क्योंकि कुछ लॉयर्स ने ये कहा था कि यहाँ के जजेस ने सुनना नहीं चाहिए ये पिटिशन. दूसरी बात ये थी कि जो हाईकोर्ट की एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कमेटी है उनके खिलाफ भी किसी ने कहा था कि कंटेम्प्ट इशू किया जाए. किसी ने आगे बढ़ के ये भी कहा था कि जो जजेस साथ में थे उनको क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन किया जाए. तो कोर्ट ने ये ऑब्जर्व किया है, कंक्लूजन ऐसा निकाला है कि कहीं ना कहीं जुडिशरी को बदनाम करने की भी कोशिश की गई है.
इन चार जजों के स्टेटमेंट्स के आधार पर, जो कि एफिडेविट पर भी नहीं आए थे, सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आज स्वतंत्र जांच की मांग ठुकरा दी. जबकि इतने सारे संदेह उत्पन्न हुए थे. उनकी फैमिली ने बोला था कि जज लोया को वहां के चीफ जस्टिस ने घूस का ऑफर दिया, उस पर भी कोई जाँच नहीं कराई गई.
The apex court said frivolous and motivated litigations have been filed to settle political rivalry. The Nagpur police, who are doing investigation in the case, said the Supreme Court has given decisions on the basis of documents and evidence presented by it.
अगर डाउट होते थे तो इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग ऑफिसर्स एजेंसी को उन्होंने मिलना चाहिए था, लेकिन वो कई सुनी बातें के ऊपर ही आगे चल के बात कर रहे थे. तो हमने जो एविडेंस कलेक्ट की है वही हमने सुप्रीम कोर्ट और बाकी अदालत में पेश की है, उसी के आधार पर ही जजमेंट हुआ है.
The petitions had sought an SIT probe into the death of Judge Lohia, who was hearing the high-profile Sohrabuddin Sheikh encounter case. Lohia had allegedly died of cardiac arrest in Nagpur on 1st December 2014 at the wedding of a colleague's daughter. Ravindra Sharon's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And the BJP and the Congress had angry exchanges after the Supreme Court verdict on Judge Lohia's death case. Welcoming the verdict, the BJP said the court vindicated the party's stand on the matter. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said the attempt to malign the image of the senior leader of the BJP has fallen flat. The party has also demanded an apology from Congress President Rahul Gandhi.
ये निर्णय सिर्फ स्वागत योग्य ही नहीं है, बल्कि एक गंभीर संदेश भी देता है कि राजनीतिक विद्वेष से आरोप लगाकर न्यायपालिका को भ्रमित नहीं किया जा सकता है. यह विडंबना है कि झूठे आरोपों के आधार पर बराबर भारतीय जनता पार्टी हमारी सरकार और दल के शीर्ष नेताओं को टारगेट करके बदनाम करने की कोशिश की जाती रही है, और मैं मानता हूं कि वह प्रयास एक बार पुनः विफल सिद्ध हुआ है।
जनहित का केस नहीं था, यह केस कांग्रेस के हित का था, और भाजपा और हमारे राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष के अहित के लिए फाइल किया गया था। जनता की लड़ाई जनता के भी चला जाए, अभी आगे कर्नाटका का चुनाव है, उसके आगे चुनाव है, पिछले क्या हुआ है कहानी देश जानता है। तो कृपया करके कोर्ट के माध्यम से देश की राजनीति को इस तरह से प्रभावित करने की कोशिश की नहीं की जाए, गलत तथ्यों पर, प्रायोजित आरोपों पर और जुडिशरी की गरिमा को गिराने के साथ।
Meanwhile, the Congress has said that the judgment left many questions unanswered and pitched for a fair probe into the matter.
किसी व्यक्ति की मौत नॉर्मल हुई या फिर संदेहपूर्वक हालात में किसी के षड्यंत्र की वजह से हुई, इसके लिए जांच की आवश्यकता है। जज लोया की मृत्यु में आज तक कोई जांच नहीं हुई। भारतीय जनता पार्टी एक जज की मौत पर भी सस्ती राजनीति करने पर उतारू है। क्या सुप्रीम कोर्ट के निर्णय में कहीं भारतीय राष्ट्रीय कांग्रेस का नाम लिखा है? क्या सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पास भारतीय राष्ट्रीय कांग्रेस या उसका कोई नेता पेटिशनर था? क्या सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पास भारतीय राष्ट्रीय कांग्रेस ने कोई दलील पेश की?
And with that, time for a very short break. Stay with us. Welcome back. You are watching News Tonight. SBI Chairman Rajneesh Kumar on Thursday assured that the problem of cash crunch being faced by some states will be resolved by Friday. He said that currency is being transported to areas which are facing the shortage. The SBI chief held cash hoarders accountable and said if people withdraw money from the bank and the money needs to be deposited back as well. Earlier today, the SBI said people in smaller towns can withdraw up to 2,000 rupees a day from the POS machines at retail outlets free of charge. As per the RBI guidelines, the withdrawal limit from POS machines at retail outlet in Tier 1 and 2 cities is 1,000 rupees per card per day and 2,000 rupees in smaller towns.
पिछले दो दिनों से सरकार ने, आरबीआई ने, दोनों ने स्थिति को बहुत स्पष्ट रूप से किया है, और आज मैं समझता हूं कि देश के 80% से ऊपर के एटीएम्स में पैसे है, जहां भी कोई जाएगा वो है।
And Union Minister Menaka Gandhi asked states to take strict action against police officers obstructing investigation or colluding with the perpetrators in cases of crimes against women and children and sought time-bound completion of investigation in such cases. The Union Minister suggested that forming a special cell only for sexual offences or for sexual offences on children could be a significant step towards curbing such crimes. She also asked the states to retrain their police officers on various aspects of sexual offences, particularly those related to the collection and preservation of evidence. In a letter addressed to the chief ministers of all the states and union territories, the Women and Child Development Minister asked them to issue instructions to all police officers that utmost priority be given to complete investigation in cases of sexual offences against children as per the timeline of the law. The letter comes amidst nationwide outcry against the rape and murder of an 8-year-old girl in Jammu and Kashmir's Kathua and rape of another minor girl in Uttar Pradesh's Unnao. A delegation led by Deputy Chief Minister and Finance Minister of Tamil Nadu, O. Paneerselvam, met the Chairman of 15th Finance Commission on Thursday. The delegation submitted a memorandum to the Commission regarding the terms of reference of the Commission and urged to balance the need for fiscal transfers to less developed states. Chairman N.K. Singh assured the delegation that the fiscal needs of each state will be individually assessed and their special characteristics will be kept in view. And now all the election news from Karnataka. B. BJP's chief ministerial candidate for the May 12th Karnataka Assembly polls, B.S. Yedurappa, on Thursday filed his nomination papers from Shikaripura Assembly segment. The BJP has set its sight on regaining power by winning 150 out of 224 Assembly seats. Yedurappa had steered the BJP to victory and formed the party's first ever government in the South in 2008. He was forced to resign as chief minister in 2011 over graft charges, following which he quit the party. He returned to the BJP ahead of the 2014 Lok Sabha polls. Former Deputy Chief Minister K.S. Ishwarappa, the party's leader in the State Legislative Council, also filed his nomination from Shivamoga Assembly segment. The filing of nominations began on Tuesday.
And I am going to get minimum 30 to 40,000 lead, and everybody is supporting all community people. And you know, they are not electing me only MLA, I am the Chief Minister candidates.
On to some more news. The Supreme Court on Thursday pulled up Jammu lawyers for obstructing the filing of charge sheet in the Kathua rape and murder case. The lawyers insisted that they were protesting on a different issue that got mixed up with the filing of the charge sheet. Asking all the parties to file their response about their incidents and the conduct of protesting lawyers, the court directed the matter for further on April 26. The Jammu High Court Bar Association told the Supreme Court that it did not support lawyers' protest in connection with the Kathua gang rape and murder case. A team has been constituted by the Bar Council of India, which will visit Kathua to assess the situation relating to lawyers' protest. The Supreme Court on Thursday also allowed the Sahara Group to choose any parcel of its properties in the Ambaye Valley City project in Maharashtra and sell them by May 15th and deposit the proceeds with SEBI Sahara refund account. The Apex Court initially asked the group to deposit 750 crore rupees by May 15th by selling the properties from one parcel of the Ambaye Valley, but later said it would not specify the amount in its order. The Supreme Court specifically told the Sahara Group that they have time till May 15th to sell the properties by themselves or these would be auctioned. It said the group will have to establish its bona fide by depositing some more money and fix the matter for hearing on May 16th. And Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu today said that people displaced from Kashmir should be settled back in their homes in their native state. He said this while releasing a book based on letters written by late BJP leader Kedarnath Sahni in Delhi. The Vice President said, people displaced from Kashmir have a right to reside once again in the valley. For this, he said Kashmiri people will themselves have to take the initiative in welcoming them back. The Vice President emphasized, it's been a long time since these people have been disposed and have suffered a lot of hardships in the process. He called it the possibility of the entire country to see them resettled. Senior BJP leaders, including Union Minister Harshvardhan, were also present on the occasion. Kedarnath Sahni was an eminent name in the social work in Jammu and Kashmir.
People of Kashmir, irrespective of political parties, they should take lead to bring back their brethren and create such an atmosphere so that they can live in their own native place in a happy manner and continue their life. That is the duty of the people of Kashmir.
And Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu on Thursday congratulated 36 students on receiving scholarships from Amar Ujala Foundation. On this occasion, the Vice President told the students that education and health should be given utmost priority and that one should not be dependent on the government alone, but should also contribute in these sectors. The Amar Ujala Foundation has given scholarships to 36 financially vulnerable children from 6 states and has given 14 lakh scholarships. And NASA launched a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket on Wednesday from Florida. The Transit Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS, is a planet-hunting orbital telescope designed to detect worlds beyond our solar system. that might be capable of harboring life. With the help of TESS, NASA expects to pinpoint thousands of unknown worlds. TESS will focus on 2 lakh pre-selected stars that are relatively nearby and among the brightest as seen from Earth. TESS will also give sensitive follow-up analysis. On to some international development, U.S. President Donald Trump expressed optimism about his planned summit with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, but said he will walk out if the meeting fails to meet his expectations. Trump said he will be meeting Kim in the coming weeks to discuss the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula. At a joint press conference with Japanese Prime Minister, Trump said maximum pressure will be maintained on North Korea over nuclear disarmament. He also added that if the meeting is not going to be fruitful, then the U.S. will walk out of it. Both the countries are in direct talks for the summit, and the last week, CIA director made a secret trip to North Korea to meet Kim.
If I think that it's a meeting that is not going to be fruitful, we're not going to go. If the meeting when I'm there is not fruitful, I will respectfully leave the meeting and we'll continue what we're doing or whatever it is that will continue, but something will happen.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.